And you said the Brooklyn Bridge? How do you know that it's the Brooklyn Bridge?
Oh, because we are so eager to come here.
You saw it?
Yes, so...
Yeah, what do you see that makes, like, what do you see that seems the same as the Brooklyn Bridge? I see you're pointing, like, this. There's this pillar in the middle, and there are these two arches right over here, like, that kind of shape, yeah? And that's a good indication, and this is the artist. People who worked at the museum, we've learned a little bit about some of the ideas Renzo Piano was sharing when he built this. And one idea was a lot of glass. We see glass even when we're downstairs between the offices and the open space. Why do you think an architect might make that choice?
This section was built by about 25 model makers over the course of an entire year. All of the sections that you see today were built in the continents that they are representing. So this over here was built in Brooklyn. To my right, to your left, is our New England section. That is,
I came and built 14 A12, costing about $40 million each. That translates to $250 million in today's currency. Now, these planes we use off and on during the 60s.
I don't need no money, no fortune, no fortune or fame. I've got all the riches, baby, that one man.
Window is going to show you the same thing you're seeing at the moment, and when you move around, the guide moves with you, labeling sites such as Statue of Liberty, Chrysler Building, Empire State Building, and more.
Happened in 49th Street, about 1.6 kilometers north of us here, and in 1968, right here on this side. So that's a quick history about where we are today. Also, this is the SAP National.
First was in Dip, the world's most famous sub-arena.
Se temiamo voci, se vai, se lena, se vuoi scoppetta, maradena.
You're both good to speak. All right, let's go. Good, good.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Irene, and she's from Lina. And so today was the last day of our exchange here in New York. And now every single one of us is very, very sad, and no one wants to go home anymore. That's because it was an incredible and unforgettable experience. Because we learned a lot more about American culture and we improved our language, we met new people, and we also became more mature and independent. And that's why we wanted to thank Mr. Fleming and all the families that hosted us, because they gave us the big opportunity to be here. And we also want to give you this gift.
This gift represents the international friendship that TD has with schools all around the world.
Beautiful.
It's made out of crystal, and it has a globe that turns around. Oh, and there's the TD motto, which says, individually focused, globally engaged. And we love how TD focuses on single students, but also give them the opportunity to make friendships with all the world. So that's what it represents, and we wanted to thank you all with this gift.
Well, in essence, it's for everybody, especially the parents, but I'll be happy to put the, my desk. I have nothing on my desk, so I really appreciate the guidance. I assure you, it will be in a prominent place. And a lot of thought went into that, I know, but a lot of effort and energy over 5 years, right? And, look at that. Okay. I don't know if you can see it. I'm standing right over here. 6 degrees of separation, but what a nice piece, a great token, and thank you very much. And I hope someday I can get to Arezzo to bring you something similar stuff. Thank you very, very much. But before we close out, look at these nails, ladies and gentlemen.
Look at these nails.
Look at those. Those are serious.